slices of key crops like coffee, macadamia, dropped through the floor. For example, macadamia last year was selling for 20 shillings per kilo. It is now selling for only 20 shillings per kilo. The coffee option has been closed for 2 months, leaving farmers desperate and in stocks that are sold and growing. We'll also know the subsidized fertilizer, another input for coffee that were coming from the coffee sharing fund that will be grown by these many funds by Jim. Farmers have also not been refunded last year's tea fertilizer subsidy. Up to now, it has forced KPA to recover the same from farmers. We also know that the subsidy for certified seeds and potatoes for farmers in Karwa, in Meru, in Nyeri, in Nakuru, in Harakwet, and other counties has also taken place. All these measures are putting pressure on farmers, traders, and business people in the region. Meanwhile, the Udar team has responded by going to Mount Kenya on a publicity stunt, launching projects that have been built by the county government. For example, Marumoro Level 4 Hospital was built by the county government of Nyeri. Also, launching projects, some of which were completed more than 2 years ago by the government of Provost Uhuru, including the Keno Marwa Road, which, as you all know, was practically complete by the time of the June election. Some projects, like the Kiganjo KCC in Nyahururu, were already launched nearly 2 years ago by the then Minister for Agriculture. This regime is yet, in fact, to complete any new project for its own. Now, because of high cost of production, most food prices, including that of milk, potatoes, cowpeas, carrots, oranges, and peas, most of these prices are up. And they are up between 5 and 14% in the last 12 months. Crops like onions are up 22%. Beans, the cost of beans is up 33%. You would think that the farmers are better off, but you'll be wrong. The farmers who produce these foods are still worse off, and they are hardly making ends meet because they are faced with huge increases in the prices of all inputs. For example, in Nyandarua, in Laikipia, to plow 1 acre of land is now 3,500, up from 2,000 just a few months ago. The so-called subsidized fertilizer turned out to be a Russian donation, now being shamelessly sold for profit. For many farmers, the fertilizer turned out to be the wrong kind of NPK instead of DAP, which has meant that farmers have to apply twice as much fertilizer per acre, and for many of them, the fertilizer arrived too late. Transport costs, as you know, are up 40% in just 12 months. But the transporters themselves are hurting. I don't think that they are making much out of this crisis, because transporters are paying 28% more for diesel. They are paying 22% more for petrol. And even yourself, in your own homes across the land, you are paying 32% more for paraffin, or if you like, kerosene. The manufacturers and traders in this region, but across the land, are faced with impossibly high costs of energy. I'm sure you all know, if you consume 200 kilowatts of electricity, the price you are now paying is up nearly 50%. While if you are a smaller consumer, consuming 50 kilowatts, you are now now paying 66% higher. So, if you had 1,000 shillings and you were buying tokens last year, you were getting 62 tokens. This year, you're only getting those tokens. These same manufacturers and traders now have to pay 3% standard tax. They also have to pay a further 3% in the housing levy, which, as you know, has been backdated July 1st this year. This has also introduced discrimination in the financing of higher education. Question we ask, how and who will determine who are able or who are better off? We think this scheme is intended to discriminate marginalized citizens. And we observe that it is these issues of the cost of living that the Kenya Kwanza administration do not want discussed and tackled at the bipartisan talks.
My name is Chacha from K24. We understand that the talks are beginning tomorrow, and it is believed there's a disgruntlement in Azimio, and especially now that Mount Kenya doesn't have a representative in the team. Is it so?
Kenya, ama Rift Valley na kingine, bei ya hizo masao